Good evening. Myself Monisha. I am from TGS Engineering College, currently pursuing final year in Electrical and Electronics Department. Today, my topic is about testing of insulator from the subject High Voltage Engineering. And these are the contents that we are going to discuss in today's class. So, the introduction. First, we will know what is an insulator. It is a material that does not conduct electrical current. The insulating materials will include paper, plastic, rubber, glass and air. Even vacuum is also an insulator, but it is not actually a material. Most electrical conductors are covered by insulation. So it does not easily allow heat, electricity, light or sound to pass through it. So next is the types of insulators. There are five main types of insulators used in transmission lines as overhead insulation. They are pin insulator, suspension insulator, strain insulator, stay and shackle insulator. Now it is the test on insulators. First, the high voltage test will include the power frequency test and impulse test. Then the test on insulators are divided into three groups. They are the type test, sample test and routine test. In these three categories, there are furthermore divisions, such as the type test will include the withstand test, dry 1 minute test, dry flashover test, 1 minute drain test, wet flashover test and the impulse frequency flashover voltage test of insulators. Then in the sample test, there will be mechanical loading test, electromechanical test, puncture test, porosity test, temperature cycle test. And in the routine test, there will be only one category, that is the mechanical routine test. So with the type test, these tests are done to determine whether the particular design is suitable for the purpose or not. So in this, first is the withstand test. Only specified voltage will be applied and a wave of 1 by 50 seconds. That is, the specified voltage will be a 1 by 50 seconds of the wave, and a flashover or puncture should not occur in this. And this test will be repeated for 5 times for each polarity. And next is the dry 1 minute test. In this, the insulator will be clean and dry and will be mounted as specified, and the prescribed voltage should be gradually brought up and maintained for 1 minute. And there should also not be any puncture or flashover during the test. Then next is the dry flashover test. In dry flashover test, the voltage shall be increased gradually until flashover occurs, and this is repeated 10 times, and there should be no damage to the insulator when this testing occurs. And the next is the 1 minute drain test. In 1 minute drain test, the insulator will be sprayed throughout the test with artificial rain drawn from a source of supply at a temperature within 10 degrees Celsius of the ambient temperature of the neighborhood of the insulator. The rain will be sprayed at an angle of 45 degrees on the insulator at the prescribed rate of 3 mm per minute. And the prescribed voltage will be maintained for 1 minute. Then next is the wet flashover test. In the wet flashover test, the voltage shall be increased gradually until the flashover occurs. And this will be repeated for 10 times. And this is also similar to the dry flashover test. And there should also not be any damage to the insulator. Then the last one is the impulse frequency flashover voltage test of insulator. So in this, the overhead outdoor insulator must be capable of sustaining high voltage surges caused by lightning. So this must be tested against the high voltage surges, and this insulator is kept as it would be used practically. Then several hundred thousand hertz very high impulse voltage generator is connected to the insulator. Such a voltage is applied to the insulator and the spark cover voltage is noted. Then next type of insulators will be the sample test. The sample test is tested fully up to and including the point of breakdown. This is done only a few samples, only on a few samples of the insulator. So in this first type will be the mechanical loading test, and here the insulator shall be mechanically loaded up to the point of failure. And this is a bending test applicable to pin type as well as the line post insulators. It will be subjected to 3 times the specified maximum breaking load for 1 minute, and as usual there should be no damage to the insulator. In case of the post insulator, the permanent set must be less than 1%, and the load is will be raised to 3 times, and there should not be any damage to the insulator and its pin. So next is the electromechanical test. This test will be carried only on suspension or tension type of insulators. This insulator will be subjected to a 2.5 times a specified maximum working tension, maintained for 1 minute, and also simultaneously 75% of the dry flashover voltage will be applied, and the insulator should withstand this test without any damage. Then next is the puncture voltage test on insulator. In this, the insulator will be first suspended in an insulating oil. Then the voltage of 1.3 times of flashover voltage will be applied to the insulator. A good insulator will not puncture under this condition. So next is the porosity test. The insulator is broken and immersed in a 0.5% alcohol solution, which will be under a pressure of 13,800 kN per meter square. The duration will be for 24 hours. So this broken insulator will be taken out and again further broken. It should not show any sign of impregnation. And next will be the temperature cycle test. So in the temperature cycle test, the insulator will be immersed in a hot water bath. The temperature will be 70 degree higher than the normal water bath for T minutes. And this cycle will the complete test will consist of 5 transfers, that is from hot to cold, cold to hot, and again from hot to cold, and like this 5 transfers will happen, and each transfer will not exceed for 30 seconds. And it is expected that the insulator should withstand the test without damage to the insulator or glaze. Here the T minutes, that is the T, will be equal to 15 plus W divided by 1.36. This is the formula for T, and where W is the weight of the insulator in kilograms. And the last point is the last type is a routine test. The routine test, basically the routine tests are applied to all insulators and will be commenced at a low voltage and shall be increased rapidly until flashover occurs for every few seconds. In this mechanical, only one type occurs in the routine test, that is the mechanical routine test. In this, the string in insulator will be suspended vertically or horizontally, and a tensile load 20% in excess of the maximum specified working load will be applied for 1 minute, and as usual there should be no damage to the string should occur. So with this, we have come to the end of this topic, and thank you.